In this session, we are going to study the next type of coding called compact code, which is Huffman code. Huffman encoding procedure is an important procedure to obtain the compact code with least redundancy. We are going to obtain least redundancy with this code. Symbols here, the first step are listed with decreasing probabilities. That is the first step. Next, we are going to consider an equation. Q is equal to R plus R minus 1 into A, where here R will be the different symbols used in the code. It can be 2, 3 or 4. Q is the number of symbols being given in the problem. The last R symbols of the source are combined to form a single composite symbol by adding their probabilities to get a reduced SA. Such symbols which are added are arranged in non-increasing probabilities. The above step is again repeated. This continues until we are left out with R symbols. So let us see the problem. Given the messages, four with probabilities 0.4, 0.3, 0.2 and 0.1. Construct a binary Huffman code. Find the efficiency and redundancy of the code. So first I arrange the code in, you can see I have arranged it in decreasing probabilities. S1, S2, S3 and S4. The first step tells you that the last R symbols have to be added to get a composite symbol. So R, what is R here? I am constructing a binary code. So here R is equal to 2. Okay. So I take the last two symbols, the last R symbols. That means the last two symbols are added. 0.2 plus 0.3, 0.1. They are added and you get 0.3. Okay, next again last two symbols are added, that is 0.3 plus 0.3, you get 0.6, which I write here. Okay, next after this I can't add because we have to stop this when, as it is told here in the procedure, when source having R symbols are left out. So here we have left out with two symbols. So initially what do I do? The last two symbols I take, I add and write it as 0.3. Next two symbols I take, I add, I write it as 0.6. But you can see here it is 0.4, 0.3, 0.3, 0.4. I should write, when I do the addition and I get a number which is greater than our that is having probabilities list. So what happens, 0.6 is greater, so I have to place it in the decreasing probability or non-increasing probability. Then now I can't add because I'm left out with last R symbols, where R is equal to 2. First symbol I give the name as 0, next I give the name as 1. So addition is forward. While coding you have to come back and code it, write the codes. Next 0.4, next 0.4, which is, what is the code here? 1. What is the code? 1. Next, these two forming a composite symbol. So what is the code for the composite symbol? 0. So when you come towards back, this 0, you are adding one more 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1 for the 0. Next coming to the first column, 0.4, what is the code? 1. 0.3, what is the code? 0, 0. 0.2 and 0.1. These two are forming a composite symbol 0.3. So what is the code for 0.3? 01. So what you're writing for that? 010 and for the 011. This is how write. Okay. Let me tell once again. The last two symbols 0.2 plus 0.1 gives you 0.3. The last two symbols 0.3 plus 0.3 gives you 0.6. You are placing it before 0.4 because I have to increase in arranging non-increasing probabilities. Then I give two symbols as R is equal to 2. I have to use either symbol 0 and 1. So I give this as 0, this as 1. Next, come back to the previous column. 0.4 is 1. I write it as it is. But 0.3 and this 0.3 are forming a composite symbol 0.6. So what is the code for this 0.6? 0. So it should be now 00 for 0.3, 01 for another 0.3. Come back to the first column, 0.4 is 1, I write as it is, 0.3, 0, 0, I write as it is. But these two are forming a composite symbol, 0.3. So what is the code for this 0.3? 0, 1. So 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, and 0, 1, 1. This is how I write. So now I tell 0.4 has got length 2, 1.3, length 2, 0.2, 3 and 0.13. So based on this, now I find what is length, average length, PI into LI, 0.4 LI is 1, 0.32, 0.23, 0.13. 0.13, 3 bits, 0, 1, 1, okay, based on that. So I get 1.9. Next, entropy, PI log 1 by PI. So I'm using 0.4 plus 0.3 plus 0.2 plus 0.1 into log of those respective to the base 2. Okay, next, I get this as my entropy. Next, I want efficiency, entropy by average length and redundancy. We can see compared to Shannon-Ternary algorithms, the redundancy, it is less. So the main application of Huffman code is getting a compact code with least redundancy. Yes, coming to the next problem, arranging given the messages 0.4, 0.2, 0.2, 0.2, 0.07, 0.03. Construct a binary Huffman code with finding the code redundancy and efficiency. So now I've arranged this, say 0.4, 0.2, 0.2, 0.1, 0.07, 0.03. In the first step, I take last two symbols. What do I get when I add 0.07, 0.03? I get 0.1. So I place it in this column, 0.1. Next, I place as it is, 0.4, 0.2, 0.1, 0.1. I place as it is, last two symbols, addition, I place this. Next, again, I place 0.4, 0.2, 0.2 as it is. And last two symbols. Why last two? Because R symbols, last R, R is 2. So last two. So 0.1 plus 0.1, I get 0.2. This 0.2 you can place at the top or you can place at the least. Both the ways it is possible. Again, I write this 0.4, again, this last two symbols I add, I get 0.4. So now I place this 0.2 here and this 0.4 here. So you're able to see this 0.2 comes here. Okay. Again, the last two symbols I can add, I get 0.6. So I place this 0.6 here and this 0.4 comes here. You can see this 0.4 coming here. Okay. So first I arrange these in decreasing probabilities. Next, last two source symbols I take, I add them, I get 0.1. Rest all I place as it is. And then these addition of these two composite symbol. Again, in the next column, I write 0.4, 0.2, 0.2. Addition of these two, I take it and write 0.2. Next, I write 0.4. Addition of last two symbols is 0.4. So what happens? That comes before your 0.2 and 0.2 comes here. Next, 0.4 plus 0.2 is 0.6, goes first and when 0.4 comes here. Next, now after having these composite symbol formed, I code this as 0. I write this as 1. 0.4, what is the code here? It is 1. So I write that 1 here. But these two together are forming the composite symbol. So what is the code for composite symbol? 0.6, 0. So when you are coming back, you write 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay. Next, 0.4 is 1. 0.2, see, you can see 0.2 is 0, 1. Okay. Next, these two symbols are forming composite symbol 0.4. So what is the code for that? 0, 0. So you get 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. This 0, 0 as it is with one more 0, 0, 0, 1. As you go back, 0 and 1, you're going on, you're adding for those symbols. Next, coming to the next column, 0.4 I write as 1, 0.2 I write as 0, 1, 0.2 I write it as 0, 0, 0. But these two symbols are giving rise to composite symbols 0.2. So what is that? 0, 0, 1, 0. 0, 0, 1, 1. Okay. Next, coming to the first, coming back, I have to fill this code table here. 0.4 is 1, 0.2 is 0, 1, 0.2 is 000, 0.1 is 0, 0, 1, 0 from the previous call. But these two, how to write? They are giving rise to composite symbol 0.1. And what is this? So what I get? 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 for the first one. Next, I get 0, 0, 1, 1. Another one. So this is how the entire table is completed. And coming to the length, you can see here 0.4 into 1, 0.2 into 2, 0.2 into 3, 0.1 into 4, 0.07 into 5, 0.03 into 5 gives you 2.3 binits message per symbol, which is your average length. And entropy is PI log 1 by PI. Average length is entropy by average length gives you efficiency, and redundancy is 1 minus efficiency. That remains the same. Only thing is, we should know to construct the Huffman code table. After forming the composite symbol, when last two symbols are left out, no formation of further composite symbol should be done, and I should write the code as 0 and 1 and come back and fill the code table. So 0.4 is 1. This 0.4 is 1. This 0.4 and 0.2, I have to code, means I should go back to the composite symbol and see what is the code. 0. So it is 0, 0, 0, 1. Next, this 0.4 is 1 as it is, I write. This 0.2 is 0, 1 from the next column I can see. These two 0.2 and 0.2 to code, I should find what is the code for the composite symbol 0.4. So it is 0, 0. So I write 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. So 1, 0 and 1. And if it is 0, it is like 0, 0. So the first symbol will have 0, 0, 0. Next symbol will have 0, 0, 1. So in this way, I come back and fill the code table and move forward and form the composite. So first form the composite symbol and next come back and fill the coding table.